And everyone knows, you know, what a passion is to them. Everyone knows, you know, how they feel about the things that, you know, bring out their expression, that bring out their creativity, but they don't. You can never truly understand anyone else's form of expression and someone else's art and passion until you talk to those people.
Mm-hmm.
So we interviewed people to truly see what theater is to them and what the community theater world, what theater as a form of expression does for them. And then we go to their interviews.
Burnett, we want you to get as deep as you can here. What is theater in your life?
What is theater in my life? Theater, it's like, theater is my life. I don't know. I work at a theater. It's everything. It kind of, because when I walk, like, through day to day, I see people going to their jobs and doing things that I think that they, to me, it doesn't make them happy. They're not, they don't seem genuinely happy when they talk about their job. They seem almost like they're supposed to say it. Like, how was work today? Oh, it was good. Like, and...
What, right now? Mm-hmm. Oh, is this okay? I'm like, sitting like a lady. Okay, but this is right. Good.
So yeah. Tell us what theater means to you.
A theater is a way for people to share their souls. The playwright shares their soul the first time when they write that script and they go through that process. And the actor brings that to life, but they also share a part of their soul, because you can put on Romeo and Juliet a million times, but it's always going to be different because you're always going to have different people.
Hopefully one day I get to make this like a job that I get to go to every single day and know that I love to do it, and it's something completely different every single day. I don't have to go to a cubicle and sit down and put in numbers into some spreadsheet and take calls from stupid people who don't understand something that's simple. And I like keeping things fresh.
It's Robbie in the bedroom. So Robbie.
What's good? All right, Maddie. Doing an documentary on community theater. All right. We need some of your Maddie Jones spice, some of your takes on it. There it is. There. There she is. On community theater and what theater means to you.
It means acting.
What? Oh, acting. Okay. The experience. Stepping into someone else's life. This isn't actually a question. Tell me about that. What's that feel like?
It feels... I mean, to me, it feels good, because my life is so hectic all the time anyway. So that's really why I do.
An escape?
No, I'm just kidding. Oh. But in reality, it's kind of is an escape. You don't really have to worry about your life. It's nice to worry about problems that I face.
Makes sense.
Actually there. But sometimes you kind of get too into it and you kind of get stuck into it.
Is this good? Do we need her to play to the camera or is it fine?
Are we okay? Are we okay?
So in that first aspect of theater, we really wanted to explore the self. So we talked to these individuals and we got some great interviews. After self, we realized something about these people, these individuals, that I thought was truly substantial and that we as a group really wanted to touch on in this documentary, and that is the community theater culture in itself. This subculture, this group of individuals and how they interact, because if anyone's ever been on a sports team or if anybody's ever been a part of any group of any kind, you know that you sort of form a culture, a family of sorts. But the theater culture is really significant, really special. I've been in plays and I've experienced that lifestyle. And it's a little crazy because everyone is completely comfortable with being themselves. And that's not to say it's a hard crowd, it's not to say you can walk in and just be anybody. You have to be really, really open.
Feel
theater is often categorized as the place for those that don't have a regular place. Ooh, they can be accepted in the theater. Ooh, isn't that sweet? Eh. The theater crowd's a tough bunch. You need to be open and honest with yourself and with them, and then with audiences. If you can't do that, the theater crowd's not interested. That's hard for a lot of people. It also is a way of making money and having fun. And those times in my life when I've been blessed to do stupid stuff and get paid cash for it, wow, what a great revelation. But it's who I am. I always have said, if I ever get paid to do it for a living, it'll feel like a vacation. And it always has. So, you know. And it's kept me alive in some of the hardest times in my life. And I lost a son back in 2009 who was 10 years old while playing football. And I quickly discovered that my 90 minutes on stage every week doing improv with my improv company was the only break I would get all week long from the grief that just ruled my life at the time. After I moved to Grand Rapids, I got a little distance from LA and all of that and where it all happened. And I realized that, hey, that same kind of exercises and games that keep people's emotions open, keep them laughing, may be able to help people. And I started a nonprofit called Healing Improv that gives workshops to people using comedy improv to help them deal with their grief. It's sort of fascinating after doing something for over a quarter of a century because you love it to find you can turn it around and help other people with it. And in doing so, help yourself because it's helped me just as much. So there's another way that theater, especially within a community, can help. It's not just seeing people up on stage performing, but it's people using the talents they've learned in theater over the years and giving them back and helping other people in need. So it runs both ways.
Are we going to get the voices of each one of us?
I'll do that.
Yeah.
Because we saw, you know, how it changed the lives of individuals. We saw how these individuals interact. But how is this helping people outside of the theater community?
Alright.
You can't throw stuff at me.
I can right now. Camera's not on.
Camera's on.
Camera is on.
Go.
We're rolling.
Community theater enriches the lives of those who participate in it, as well as people who have the benefit of live theater. In the United States, there are around 7,000 theaters. In Grand Rapids alone, there are roughly 10, including Civic Theater, Actors Theater, Heritage Theater, and did I say Civic Theater? I want Civic Theater to be the last one. Civic Theater has around 800 volunteers. Around 800 volunteers, and the national average is around 200. This is a huge theater. Civic Theater is responsible for entertaining over 120,000 patrons. That's dope. That's half the population of Grand Rapids. Having to crack.
I think we're golden. Birthday.
So, it is amazing to find out a not-for-profit professional theater field attract over 31 million audience members to 163,000 performances of 16,000 productions in total of 1.4 million. Our Americans subscribe to theaters every season. I mean, that's a pretty big number.
Because
we've been around
this now. We've filmed all sorts of crazy people. So
that's good.
You know, what's your
response? Well, I can say something kind of off Shane, you know, like these 18-year-olds and these 60-year-olds who normally would take a lot of time to be comfortable with each other, it's like they've been living together their whole lives. Mm-hmm. The way they're so comfortable around each other. Yeah.
Of real people coming out on stage, of people stepping into an entirely different person. Where have you seen that in life? Like, how does that empathy apply to you as an individual? You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, every time an actor steps on stage, they have to become a different person. They have to imagine these feelings, and you know, they often take these feelings from their own existence and their own lives.
I mean, just talk about them. Be like a couple of my friends who have been in different performances, just exuberate confidence.
Yeah, just like what qualities of community theater make it a marketable enterprise?
Well, I think if you look at it, you see people on stage, and then the next day they make great friends. You could have an 18-year-old person who's playing sport making great friends with a 50 or 60-year-old. There's no such thing as age limits. Everyone can make friends, make groups. They meet up at different times. I think that's something that's needed in society. I think, you know, it's very, people make their own groups and they can judge people. But I think in this sort of situation, people are friends and there's no judging other people. You get me?
All right, I'm here with Bruce Tinker.
Hello.
There it is. All right. So, first off, what do you do? Who are you? What's your title?
I'm the executive and artistic director of the Grand Rapids Civic Theater in Grand Rapids, Michigan.
All right. It's pretty professional sounding. Okay. So, you've been here at Civic Theater for a pretty long time. What have you seen in terms of the community, how it's helped?
Oh.
Or, I mean, how it's hurt, maybe, if that's...
No, no. Grand Rapids is an incredible city.
Okay.
I mean, it's an incredibly philanthropic city, but the community theater here in Grand Rapids is really unique. It's really an incredible group of theaters of all stages and all, you know, all sizes, all stages of development. Mm-hmm. And we all have really interesting, distinct missions and a way to serve them. And I think that, you know, we all work together. I mean, we really try to support each other, and we try to keep it a healthy competition, and we encourage, you know, the volunteers to move between the theaters and, you know, just follow your bliss, follow the show. Don't worry about any of us individually. Love to have everyone involved, love to have people involved, but we really do encourage people to be involved everywhere.
As far as a business aspect goes, you know, we're really trying to touch and see what community theater does for individuals and what it does, you know, for relationships within a community, see if it actually has an impact. But as far as economically and, like, from the business side of it, what do you think the community theater and civic theater specifically is doing economically?
Well, we know that local theater will return, you know, 95% of what it earns back into the economy of the local economy and the theater.
Right.
We employ a number of people, both full-time staff, but also our part-time staff, our teachers, guest directors, are all employed locally, and they're all local talent. We almost never bring someone from the outside. And again, we have a great community of guest artists here in the community as well, guest directors, designers, musicians that we can employ locally. We help the restaurant trade in the sense that, you know, most people want to grab a bite before or after the show. You know, there's that sort of thing. But it also, again, we serve as a gathering place. There's a lot of networking that happens before or after a show or an event, you know, an opening night party or, you know, any number of receptions we have. You know, you provide that kind of access. We provide great entertainment for local corporations. We had a corporate sponsor tell us once, it's just real interesting. We use Civic Theater for company entertainment, but we use it for our employees to entertain their friends and neighbors again, not necessarily to entertain our clients. That's every bit as valuable as client entertainment, is, again, empowering that employee with, you know, the gift of tickets and the gift of an experience that they can share with someone that's close to them.
Yeah.